We took this massive 8-foot aquarium and over $10,000 worth of fish to our very first expo appearance.
And set up a custom display tank right at the front entrance. And well, here's how that turned out.
When we got invited to join the Melbourne Pet Show this year, we knew right away that we had to either go big or go home. So we wanted to give it our absolute best. We also wanted to show off how resourceful and creative we can be. So we decided that instead of using a brand new tank and setting it up on the spot, we would instead take this old 8x3x2 aquarium and use it to create a custom display tank. And to make it even more difficult, we decided to still go ahead with the plans once we found out we only had 2 days to set up and 1 day to pack up. Oh yeah, and also we decided to put $10,000 worth of fish in it. Anyway, things never go to plan, so here's what happened from the beginning.
Welcome back to Obsidian Exotics, and as you can see, it's horrible outside. It's pouring down rain. It's only about 8:30 in the morning, but we have till about 12 o'clock to get everything ready to start moving stuff into the expo venue. We got from 12 o'clock to 5 o'clock today, so we've only got 5 hours today to get the big tanks in, get the rack systems in, fill them all up with water, and then yeah, start, I guess, making the place look nice. We'll see how we go, because it's gonna be a horrible day with this weather. I was hoping to get some really nice drone shots, which I don't think I'll get a chance to do now. But yeah, wish us luck.
Luckily, the rain had stopped as I got to where the big tank was. So after Toby and I had cleaned up the tank and got it ready for transport, we quickly made a drive to the local Bunnings so we can get some last minute plumbing supplies and the tiles we planned on using for the base of the aquarium. When we got back, my friend Tyson had showed up just in time to help us load up the tank, stand and the sump into our vans. Once we got everything loaded up, we headed straight to Melbourne Showground so we could get started on our stall right away. When we arrived, we quickly unpacked our vans and moved the tank and stand inside, where we came to realize we have a problem. Well, two problems actually.
So we got the tank in and we got the stand in. We didn't get the tank on top of the stand because it's too heavy and we don't have enough people to do it. But we'll do that the next time around when there's more people. But now the main problem is, because it was originally two different stalls that we bought and then combined, they put a cross brace in the middle and a pole at the front. Now because of this, we can't quite fit our 8-foot tank that we brought over. And because we were told the stall is 8-foot tall, we made our cabinets and the hood and everything to be 8-foot tall, which means now it hits the cross brace. So I've managed to talk to the management and they're gonna get rid of that for us. And hopefully when we get back with the smaller racks, it'll be gone and we can get it into position, and hopefully we have more people by then so we can get the tank on top of the stand as well.
While the event managers modified our stall to make our big tank fit at the front, we left to go and get the racks and all the dry goods. When we got back, we remembered that we couldn't organize anyone to come help us. With no other option left, we got one of the forklift drivers at the venue to lift the massive tank into place where Toby and I planned on temporarily holding it in place so the forklift can pull out. And that didn't exactly go to plan, and I nearly tore both my biceps. Luckily for us, the forklift driver called in a couple of other workers to help us out, and we finally managed to get the tank on the stand. Unfortunately, by then it was time for us to leave the venue, and we didn't get to do majority of the things we needed to get done on the day. We went home feeling pretty disappointed, but hopeful that we could get everything done on the final day. Neither one of us slept that night, as we spent all night preparing for the next day.
Cut all these tiles for the tank tomorrow, so I'll try and be quiet as possible.
Alright, we're on our way to Melbourne Showgrounds again. I've got about 500 litres of water in the back in the IBC, and I managed to convince my family to come help me quickly readjust the tank because we couldn't quite get it right yesterday because it was just me and Toby. And a forklift, which didn't go very well. My arms are still pretty much useless, so we'll see how that goes. But we're gonna have to pick it up for a millisecond and quickly adjust the sponges on it. because the foam underneath isn't quite sitting well. So I want to readjust that. Once that's in place properly, we will hopefully fill it up and not have any issues. So fingers crossed.
As we arrived at the venue, we got straight to work. We quickly lifted up the tank to tear out the styrene base that was now stuck to the bottom of the tank and causing it to not sit flat on the rubber. Once that was done, I started filling up the tank with the water that I brought over and then chucked in two heaters to keep the water warm. Since we were going to have some very rare and expensive fish in this tank, we didn't want to take any risk at all, and we brought all the water we needed from my existing tanks. While we're on the topic of fish, let me show you what we planned on putting in the tank. With almost $8,000 worth of stingrays and almost $3,000 worth of giant gouramis, when we combined the total of all the fish we were bringing, it was well over $14,000 in just livestock. Now I have to remind all my overseas viewers that these prices are Australia only. I understand that these are a lot cheaper for you guys, but unfortunately we don't have the same luxuries of being able to import any fish we want. Anyway, back to the video. By the time I got back with the second load of water, Toby had gotten most of the rack systems in place and started stocking products on the shelves. And as I finished with the water, my dad arrived with the custom cabinet and hood. While they got to work on getting the wooden panels around the steel stand, I went to collect water for a third time. This was when I realized that due to the bad traffic during rush hour, we won't have enough time to get the fish in the tank that night. After I got back, we managed to fill the tank enough to turn the return pump on, but unfortunately we didn't have enough water for all the small tanks on the rack system. We partially filled them up and left the venue with so much work left to do and not enough time. We went home that night feeling exhausted, knowing that we had our second sleepless night ahead of us.
So it is about 7 in the morning. We're rushing to the expo with all my fish in the back. We've got two IBCs this time. There's a bunch of stingrays, bunch of giant gouramis, but they won't let us access from the back door anymore. So we're gonna have to walk through the front of the venue and just run with a net full of fish. Hopefully we don't make too much of a mess, because we've got 2 hours before the actual expo starts. I think we're doing okay. We still have to fill up half of the small tanks because we didn't get to do that yesterday. Also because of traffic, I didn't get to run through all the water like I originally planned. I only got to do like three trips, whereas originally I wanted to do about 5 trips. We'll see what happens. We have to also finish off some of the cabinets. We also have to do the lighting and label some of the products, make them look nice. So much to do, but we'll see what happens.
2 hours to spare, we got all the fish in the tank and filled up the smaller tanks. Unfortunately, our big display tank was cloudy for the first few hours of the show, but we still thought it looked pretty impressive. Once the doors opened, we finally saw that all our hard work had paid off. We were absolutely swarmed the entire time we were there. We also got the attention of some of our fellow YouTubers.
Far out. That's a solid unit. That is huge.
They had this big display here with some epic fish and some rays in there. I'm not going to try and guess what type of fish these are.
Day 2 of the expo was no different, with massive crowds continuing to swarm our display tank the entire day. The best part was that our tank was finally crystal clear thanks to the magical Clear-X powder that was given to us by the awesome guys at Dymex, which we are forever grateful for. And also a shout out to Ray from Aquapet for bringing us some more. Also, an alarmingly large amount of people really wanted to kiss the fish in the tank, so we constantly had to wipe up the glass because there were so many lip prints. Which we're more than happy to do, and we're not here to judge. You do you, I guess. But also maybe get tested, because who knows who else kissed the glass, and you might have caught something now of a public display. Anyway, after another successful day at the pet show, it was now time for us to pack up. And this time, we were a bit more prepared. Massive shout out to my loving family, and also my friends Sean, Sam, Alicia, and Zach for being absolute lifesavers. And helping Toby and I pack up in record time. We actually managed to pack it all up in under 3 hours, which is absolutely insane. This was such a crazy experience for us, and no doubt we will be back again next year with bigger and crazier setups. Thank you to everyone who helped us get this far in our journey, and I'd like to invite you all to join us as we continue to chase our dreams.